This is the fifth part of Amazon EKS tutorial. In this section, we'll cover EKS Pod Identities and Cluster Autoscaler. Cluster Autoscaler is an external component that you need to additionally install in your EKS cluster to automatically scale up or down your cluster. If you remember, EKS node groups are created as regular AWS Autoscaling groups with maximum, minimum, and desired size properties. When Autoscaler detects any pending pods in your cluster, it will adjust the desired size property on the autoscaling group to fit all the pods. Keep in mind, if you created your EKS using Terraform, you may need to explicitly ignore this property in the code. Otherwise, Terraform and Autoscaler will keep updating the same property when you run Terraform apply. Additionally, Cluster Autoscaler needs permissions to interact with AWS and adjust the desired size. So we need to authorize it somehow. Previously, we used OpenID Connect Provider, and it was a bit complicated. You had to create OpenID Connect Provider on the IAM side, then create IAM role and establish trust with a particular namespace and RBAC service account. The most annoying part about OpenID Connect Provider was having to use annotation with IAM role I ran on the service account. Now, EKS team has developed a new approach called EKS Pod Identities that we can use to grant access. To enable it, you can use EKS add-on, which is super easy to install. You still need to create IAM role for the Kubernetes service account, but for the trust, you use the same pods EKS Amazon AWS.com. Also, to bind IAM role with a service account, we don't use annotations anymore. Instead, you use EKS API and Pod Identity Association resource. First of all, we need to deploy EKS Pod Identity agents as a daemon set. This agent will run on every single node in your cluster. The easiest way to install it is to use EKS Managed add-on. You just need to specify the cluster name, the add-on name, and the latest version. To find the latest version of any specific add-on, you can run the following command: describe add-on versions. The latest version for now is 1.2.0. If you find a new version, just update it in the Terraform code. Alright, let's go ahead and run Terraform. Make sure that the agent is running. I have a single node, so I have only one agent pod. You can also get a daemon set just to check that all agents are running. Without the agent running, you won't be able to authorize your client with AWS services. Next, let's create all necessary components for the cluster autoscaler. First of all, we need a role, and for the trust relationship, you will always use pods.eks.amazonaws.com. When using OpenID Connect Provider, you had to specify the namespace and the service account name under trust policy. Next, we need to create a policy that allows the cluster autoscaler to access AWS autoscaling group. Then we attach this policy to the IAM role for the autoscaler. Finally, we need to associate this with a Kubernetes service account. You still need to provide a namespace where autoscaler will be running and the Kubernetes service account name. Next, we need to deploy it to EKS. Let's do this by using Helm chart as well. Don't forget to update the region for the autoscaler. When we used OpenID Connect Provider, we had to add additional annotation and pass it as a Helm argument. I use metric server as a dependency, just to follow tutorial. You can use node group instead to deploy multiple Helm charts in parallel. Let's run Terraform apply one more time. Now, we have the cluster autoscaler running. In case your pods remain in pending state and do not trigger autoscaling, the best place to find an error is autoscaler log. At least for the first time, keep tailing logs and check for any errors. To test autoscaling, we'll use a deployment with 5 replicas, and don't forget to define the resource block as well. Since I have only one node cluster, it wouldn't be enough. Let's watch the nodes. And in the second tab, let's watch the pods. It's time to apply deployment. You can see that only 2 out of 5 pods are being scheduled. Another way to check if your cluster will be scaled up is to describe one of the pending pods. And under the events section, you'll see the message that the pod triggered or didn't trigger autoscaling. In about a minute or so, EKS should add additional nodes. I have another tutorial that covers Karpenter and Keda autoscaling. And don't forget to delete this example. In the following section, I'll cover AWS Load Balancer Controller, how to use it to create network load balancers, as well as ingresses, and secure it with TLS certificates.